Good morning. Welcome to the land of light and shadow. We're on the Oregon Dunes. Well, my wife and I decided to make a quick trip to the Oregon coast, and we're camped at a campground right next to these Oregon Dunes. And so I thought I'd try to get here this morning and look for something to photograph. You know, you would think it'd be easy just to, there should be something here, you know, this kind of photography is super easy. It's just shadow and light. But getting that right mixture, you know, good balance, that's the hard part. So we're going to keep looking, and I think I might just head the opposite direction I went last time. I think right now the light on this side over here looks better, so we may be hiking across this little valley and checking out these dunes over here today, because I've already been that way once. And just standing right here, it's just a beautiful view doesn't necessarily mean a beautiful photograph though, so I need to find something to photograph. All right, well, off we go. Well, I'm looking for a clean piece of sand. Been a few people out here this week. And I'm looking for shapes that I can use with the shadow. And really, you would think that's easy, but it's really fairly abstract in nature often, and it can be difficult. Don't really want to point the camera just at anything. I'm seeing a lot of close where I'm thinking, oh, we're getting close to something, like this right here. I love the layers and the texture, but I'm not sure if this is enough to make me stop him. You know, once you start commit to a shot, it takes a while, so even in digital, but I might make a few frames here. This a little bit more into the sun than I'd like, but I kind of like the layered effect. We got a light section right through the middle. This is purely just light and shadow. Super, super minimalist. And there might be something up here too. This might be where we start making our first shots. The trick is, when you're shooting dunes, is to be aware of your footprints. I want to shoot from further away and then work my way closer. And as the closer I get, there might be new shots that show themselves. But if I start close and move my way back, then of course I'm shooting over my tracks. And I'd rather not do that. So I'm starting at the bottom of these dunes, and I'm going to kind of work my way up and see what we can find. But that's the first shot. There's a lot of real subtle stuff out here, which is kind of my style of photography. If you get my photography, often you get the subtle. I'm often surprised when someone gets what I'm trying to do with the photograph, because it can be on the vague side sometimes. It can be a bit subtle. But there are some people once in a while that know exactly what I was trying to do, whether it's successful or not. And those are the people that probably subscribe to my channel. So you can tell there's not a whole lot of them. All right, let's move up. I still think I can work in this area here, so I'm gonna do some more shooting here, but I need to recompose. Well, I've moved up the dune a little bit. I'm closer now, and I'm attracted to this pattern in the foreground that kind of leads the eye along this side of this dune. These are really simple shots. I'm just shooting fairly quickly and moving because the light's changing pretty fast. There's something on the other side of the dune I wanted to try with a little bit longer lens. But I really wanted to try to get, I just love these swooping lines and it's just simple stuff, you know. But since I don't see this stuff very often, to me it's like, oh, how exciting. It's just, oh man, the dunes are just beautiful. But in the short time I've been out here, I can already see that the light has changed so much. So I've got to work fairly quickly this morning to get, before the sun gets too high and then it just flattens out the dunes. These aren't huge dunes. They're just, there's nothing real dramatic about them, but it gives you a chance to play with the light and the shadow. That's all we're doing really, just playing. Well, the spot I thought looked pretty good like 15 minutes ago, maybe 20 minutes ago. The sun's already moved enough to where it doesn't have the shapes that I was seeing before. But I think this might be an interesting spot in the evening. I'm gonna try it in the evening. I think I'm gonna come back here tonight and I'll show you what I'm looking at. There, I don't know if you can see this, but there's some kind of S curves through this sand right here that the sun is shining this direction. Might cast some interesting shadow. If this was winter, the sun would really stay fairly low for quite a while. But because this is still sort of summer, there's just not quite enough angle to get the texture I'm wanting out of these dunes right now. At least these here. And I don't want to trample over them while the light's not that good. But there's a lot to play with here in the shapes. I think I can work around in here. So we'll come back. I think this is where my evening shoot will be, right here. And that's part of the deal. You gotta kind of plan out your shoot. When you're not familiar with the spot, a lot of it's just planning for a later shoot. There's so much ground to cover and there's not a shot everywhere, you know? It's just kind of have to look for the light and shadow and chase it. And this morning, I chased it to this spot, this location, and I think that's all I'm going to get. That's all right. I need to go head back to camp and eat some food. Getting kind of hungry anyway. So we'll continue this. Just a little bit. Oh, I'm back, and this is the other end of the day. I'm back at the same location I was this morning, and I'm photographing these little squiggly lines, these little shapes, I don't know what shape that is, but they're repeating and they kind of go up the dune here. And this is kind of what I was picturing this morning, but the light was at a different angle, and I was thinking that if I came back in the evening, there might be some interesting texture here. Now, I don't know if this was worth the walk. It was quite a walk out here. But I'm going to, this light's still getting better. I probably have about an hour left to shoot. But I'm gonna shoot this and then walk around here and see what else I can find. My heart wants to take every piece of gear I can bring with me just in case. I should have listened to my head. My head said, you know, you might want to go back with a lighter load. It was a lot this morning. Well, I didn't listen to my head. I packed all my gear for probably no good reason. This should have been pared down to a really light kit because it's a lot of work getting out here. Part of the problem with shooting these dunes is the everything's so far apart. So once you commit to a certain area, it takes so long to get to another spot, you're really kind of stuck with what you got. And this is where I decided I was going to come this morning. I said, I'm coming back here. I'm going to work this area. I think that the Oregon Dunes is one of those things where you need, you know, 3 or 4 days to really just kind of wander around and find things. And 1 day isn't going to cut it. I'm just going to have a few shots, and I'm hoping for one or two that I go, ooh, I like that. Fingers crossed. You know, you kind of put all your eggs in a basket. This is the basket I chose today. So I better get to shooting, because the light is going to go fast. I'm shooting with my 85, and I'll probably start switching to wider lenses as I move in a little bit closer, just to see if there's another focal length that will give another look, you know. The telephoto, the short telephoto, is compressing the scene a little bit. It's really focusing in all the repeating lines. I might zoom in on a couple of them with, or get close to one or two of them with the wide angle lens, and show them in a different, totally different way. We'll see. I don't want to get too close and mess up something that, you know, it's a gamble, because if I get too close and then the sun gets to a certain spot and that spot all of a sudden got better, I ruined my shot. So I'm trying to be a little bit careful here. But I think I'm getting what I want with the telephoto, so I might try a couple with the wide shots. Might even put the 4x5 on there, we'll see. I got to get back to camp. It's been a pretty productive shoot. A couple hours in the morning, a couple hours in the afternoon. So I'm going to end today's video right here. So until next time, thanks for coming along for the ride.